Hi, I'm Joshua Yadav. In this video, I'm going to discuss why is it important for you to understand the different orientation of entrepreneurship. But first, what is entrepreneurial orientation? Entrepreneurial orientation, or EO, is a key concept when executives are crafting strategies in the hopes of doing something new and exploiting opportunities that other organizations cannot exploit. EO refers to the processes, practices, and decision-making styles for organizations that act entrepreneurially. Any organization's level of EO can be understood by examining how it stacks up relative to five dimensions: versus autonomy, competitive aggressiveness, innovativeness, proactiveness, and risk-taking. These dimensions are also relevant to individuals. First, autonomy. Autonomy refers to whether an individual or team of individual within an organization has the freedom to develop an entrepreneurial idea and then see it through to completion. In an organization that offers high autonomy, people are offered the independence required to bring a new idea to fruition and unfettered by the shackles of corporate bureaucracy. When individuals and teams are unhindered by organizational tradition and norms, they are able to more effectively investigate and champion new ideas. The next is competitive aggressiveness. Competitive aggressiveness is the tendency to intensely and directly challenge competitors rather than trying to avoid them. Aggressive moves can include price cutting and increased spending on marketing, quality, and production capacity. An example of competitive aggressiveness can be found in any number of attack ads of a product. Too much aggressiveness can undermine an organization's success. A small firm that attacks larger rivals, for example, may find itself on the losing end of a price war. Establishing a reputation for competitive aggressiveness can damage a firm's chances of being invited to join collaborative efforts such as joint ventures and alliances. In some industries, such as the biotech industry, collaboration is vital because no single firm has the knowledge and resources needed to develop and deliver new products. Executives, thus, must be wary of taking competitive action that destroy opportunities for future collaborating. Third is innovativeness. Innovativeness is the tendency to pursue creativity and experimentation. Some innovation builds on existing skills to create incremental improvements, while more radical innovation requires brand new skills and make existing skills obsolete. Either way, innovativeness is aimed at developing new products, services, and processes. Those organizations that are successful in their innovation efforts tend to enjoy stronger performance than those that do not. Known for efficient services, FedEx has introduced its smart package, which allows both shippers and recipients to monitor package location, temperature, and humidity. This type of innovation is a welcome addition to FedEx lineup for those in the business of shipping delicate goods such as human organs. Next is proactiveness. Proactiveness is the tendency to anticipate and act on future needs rather than reacting to events after they unfold. A proactive organization is one that adopts an opportunity-seeking perspective, such as organization act in advance of shifting market demand, and are often either the first to enter new market or fast followers that improve on the initial efforts of first movers. The last is risk-taking. Risk-taking refers to the tendency to engage in bold rather than cautious actions. Starbucks, for example, made a risky move in 2009 when it introduced a new instant coffee called Bia Ready Brew. Instant coffee has long been viewed by many coffee drinkers as a bland drink, but Starbucks decided that opportunity to distribute its product in different make-at-home format was worth it. The risk of associating its brand name with instant coffee. Although a common belief about entrepreneurs is that they are chronic risk takers, research suggests that entrepreneurs that do not perceive their action as risky and must take action only after using planning and forecasting to reduce uncertainty, but uncertainty seldom can be fully eliminated. And that is the reason why we must understand the different orientation in entrepreneurship, because we can use them when we decide to become entrepreneurs, and we can take advantage of them because entrepreneurial orientation being a strategic approach considerably, promotes various innovation in the firm. It is considered an important tool to facilitate information relating to innovation and superior business and performance. And that is all. Thank you for listening.